We are at a different tiny prefab cabin in Canada today, again by our friends over at Lloyoll Prefabs. I'm repping some of their new hat swag as I speak to you. In a previous video, we toured one of their gorgeous salty models right on the beach. Today, we're at one of their Skali units deep in the woods. It's a backcountry cuboid unit made out of weathering steel, and it's a little over 400 square feet. It's called the Midway River Getaway, and it is on Airbnb. We're about 2 hours outside of Halifax, Nova Scotia, and it's on 13 acres of private land that is right near a river. I really like all of the outdoor space, and I would say the interior is very focused on the lofts and the fireplace. It's super cozy. Last but not least, make sure you stick around to the end because I'll be doing a quick cost breakdown on this cabin, and there's a link down below to build and price any of Lloyoll's models on their website. It's a lot of fun. There's just so many different layers of customization that you can do. I could get lost in it for hours. So link down below to do that. But ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's now go and start the full tour. Welcome back to Canada and to another prefab cabin by Lloyoll Prefabs. I really loved the weathered steel look on this unit. It blends in perfectly to this wooded setting, and the steel is very strong and meant to withstand the elements. But I'm now gonna quickly get a fire going. You have those four simple chairs around the fire pit. I think this is all perfect for a couple or a small family to escape into the woods for a few days. And this is the river right across the street from the cabin, the Midway River, and you have 13 acres of land right along this beauty to take in the great outdoors. But I'm now gonna walk behind the cabin, and this is what the back exterior looks like. You do have a simple grill, so you can have a little barbecue during your stay if you'd like, but I'm now gonna get a little closer and open up the entrance door because I think it's now finally time to go and see the interior. Straight ahead through the entrance, you can see the wood stove already burning. I think this stove is definitely the centerpiece of this cabin. But the host left behind plenty of fire starting supplies. The wood was already even laid out. I just had to light a match. But as you can see, there is plenty of kindling and logs to get a fire up and running. And if we now pan up, you can see how tall the ceiling is in this cabin. I also really loved all the tiling behind the wood stove, and some of these shots were taken from up in the loft looking down. More on the lofts in just a little bit, but definitely a very cozy setting. Let's now go and see the rest of the ground floor. So if we look beyond the wood stove to the right, you can find the one bedroom on this floor, and it has a queen mattress in it. Now, back towards the entrance door, there are some hangers where you can put your jackets and coats. Next, I'll go through this way, and this will take us into the bathroom. There's a lot of gray tiles here, pretty similar to some of the tiling we saw behind the wood stove, but you have this large walk-in shower, and this is your sink and mirror. Let's now go and see the other half of this floor, which is made up of your kitchen. You have a lot of key appliances like your stovetop and toaster oven, and some are hidden behind cabinets like your fridge and freezer units shown here. If I look in this direction, your countertop wraps around, so you have plenty of space to do some cooking if you need to during your stay. But I'm now gonna climb up this ladder because I wanna go and see some of the loft space. Looking up, you can already see two beds up there. They are both single mattresses, I believe, so great for the kiddos if you're just staying here, or perhaps if a family has purchased a unit like this for their vacation home. You do have these cubes for some extra storage space, and both of the loft areas on either side of this wall are pretty much exactly the same. If I now look out from the loft, you can see those two walls, which are made up pretty much entirely of windows. There's also another loft closer to the kitchen. In this unit, it wasn't utilized, but you can definitely put another bed up there or perhaps use it for some extra storage space. Next, I'll briefly mention that I was able to go to the Lloyoll Prefab shop to see some of the new units that they're working on. I also met the founder, Jonathan, who is very clearly passionate about his work and an overall cool dude. And if you haven't seen my previous video, we toured one of their salty units shown here. They're made out of bleached cedar wood and are perfect to be placed in more of a beach or water setting. But let's not go and do a cost breakdown for the units we toured today. Okay, time for another mini cost breakdown. This time for one of Lloyoll's Skali units, like the one that we toured in today's video. For the first step, I'm going to go back to the Lloyoll Prefabs website and click on their Skali webpage. The home that we toured today was a Skali Back Country Cuboid unit. It's actually the smallest of the three available Skali sizes, and it's about 400 square feet total. Same as the last video, I'm going to click build in price and put my hometown in New Jersey as the delivery location. Please again, take into account that Lloyoll is based in Canada. This will take us to the exterior portion. I'll be keeping the base packages for the most part. For this particular one, it is the black aluminum trim. Next, we'll shift to the interior where you'll select your finishing. You have some great options like birch, cedar planks in Douglas fir, and maple, but I'm just gonna stick with birch and go to the next part. For the timbers, I'll keep the hemlock, rough sawn, and natural finish, which is the base package. After that, we'll come to windows and doors. You actually have two base package options. I personally prefer the color black, so I'm gonna choose this option on the right. We then have countertops, keeping the base package here. I'll choose black for the hardware and fixtures and keep going. For the bathroom, it looks like we have two options. You can actually get a copper sink for about $3. So I'm gonna splurge. Copper sink it is. For heating and power, I'm going to click on just power up your home. And you might have seen it in the last video, but I think having an off-grid power source is a great option. So I'm gonna spend the extra $2,500 on the off-grid prep package. Finally, I'll decline all further upgrades and accessories to go to the confirmation page. I'll scroll down the summary page, and it looks like my customized home comes out to about $307,000 Canadian, or about $225,000 US. For comparison, in the last video for the salty unit, that one came out to about $280,000 US, but it was a much larger home. So be sure to go and watch the last video. But I hope you guys enjoyed this mini prefab cabin and cost breakdown mini series. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll see you very soon for another Airbnb tour.